right, what's going on? You know who it is. You know what it is. All right, man. Yeah, man, I was checking out Dr. Boyce Watkins' channel when I went and did some research myself. But, yeah, man, this is very disturbing to see this happening to a young black man. But in case you guys don't know, man, there are reports that Sean Kingston is completely broke. That homeboy may have only $7 to his name. They're saying that his bank accounts, that he has two bank accounts. They say one of them was negative $200 and the other one only has $7 in it, because apparently he owed his lawyer some money and apparently his lawyer sued him and they asked him to open up his books and, you know, his, you know, accounts, and they looked and checked his accounts and one of his accounts was like negative $200 and another one only has $7 in it. So, man, that's sad, man. But this is what I was trying to tell you, man. A lot of these rappers, man, be fronting this shit. They don't have what they be pretending to have on these videos. That's why I be trying to tell y'all, don't get caught up watching these damn rap videos where these dudes driving Ferraris and all that type of shit, because it's just props for the video, man. Most of the time, the record label rent all that shit. I mean, if you know, there was a video about fronting by the Roots called What They Do. Go check that video out. And they just basically break down some of the bullshit that go on in rap videos. It's an old school track by the Roots called What They Do. Great video. But yeah, man, this shit with Sean Kingston is just it's just disturbing, man. To see that, you know, somebody like him is down to a measly $7 in his bank account. And this is why, you know, guys like me, 7-8, and a couple of other people went off on you punk motherfuckers, you know, that was talking shit about Kendrick Lamar buying his sister a Toyota Camry. It's an economy car, and one, the maintenance on the Camry is relatively cheap. You motherfuckers don't know how expensive the maintenance is on a fucking Ferrari, in a fucking Mercedes-Benz and car like that. Did you know a tune-up on a Bentley coupe is like anywhere from $3,000 to $5,000? But y'all think Kendrick Lamar should be buying his sister some shit like that, right? Who the fuck gonna pay for it? And more than likely, Kendrick Lamar would be on tour and shit. So if the car break down or something and she need to get it fixed, well, where the fuck she supposed to get the money from? And I'm gonna be honest with you, probably the main motherfuckers that was talking that shit about Kendrick Lamar was probably you broke ass niggas that work at Walmart, that drive your girlfriend's shit, drive her car to work, and don't, you know what I'm saying, if you wasn't with her, you wouldn't have no way to get to work. Cause usually that's the type of motherfuckers that be talking that shit. And as far as the bitches go, probably the bitches that was hating on Kendrick Lamar was probably these broke ass, you know, pushing the stroller, four kids by six different men. And yes, I said six different men, because out of the, you know, four kids, there are six possible fathers. So there's a couple of maybes. But those were the main culprits talking that shit about Kendrick Lamar buying his sister a Toyota Camry. And probably for the hating ass whites and non-blacks, was just a bunch of jealous ass motherfuckers anyway that just hate to see black people doing shit for other black people. But yeah, at the end of the day, man, it's a very unfortunate situation for Sean Kingston. I hope it gets better for him. But see, that's what happens, one, when you make a decent amount of money at a young age and you don't take care of it and shit. And then also, when you have a whole bunch of motherfuckers in your pockets and shit, leeches and shit. This isn't the first time. And I'm going to tell you guys a story, too. Now, it was a rapper, I ain't gonna say what his name is, but he was in a Bay Area hip-hop group that was out of Oakland. And they had a record deal with MCA. I ain't gonna say the name of the group neither, you know, just out of respect for homeboy. But I just want to show you that these dudes don't be making the type of shit off records that you think they make. I could break down the record industry for you, because, you know, I dabbled in that industry. But anyway, you know, the dude had a record that was out on MCA, but the dude was working at Bay Area Beverage with me back in the day. But I ain't going to say the dude's name. But Yeah, man, that just goes to show you. And then it was another Oakland rapper. You know, he had a hit, you know, he had a couple of hit records. And at the time, this dude was catching a bus and shit. So, you know, I'm trying to tell you, man, don't be fooled by that shit you see, you know, on TV and shit. Because like I said, a lot of these dudes be faking the funk. You know, go check that song out, you know, Main Ingredient, you know, Faking the Funk, you know, from the White Man Can't Jump soundtrack. But anyway, man, like I said, man, this shit with Sean Kingston, man, it's very sad, man. And like I say, man, my thoughts and prayers is going to be with the brother, and I hope his situation get better. But yeah, man, it's sad to hear about some shit like this. You don't never want to hear, you know, this about a, you know, a young black man going through some shit like this. But like I said, man, this is what happens when you don't take care of your money and when you don't have the right type of people around you helping you take care of your money. But anyway, man, I'm out.